Welcome to the P1 program. This lecture is called P106.2. In this lecture, we are going to look at the orbital equation, right? So orbit equation is the point of concern in this lecture. So what is orbit equation? So before going into that, let's recap what we have done earlier. So in the last lecture, so far we have done, what we have done is that we have found out the, for the case of a particle or a material that is being thrown, a ball being thrown by a person, we found out that the trajectory of this path would be a parabolic path if there is no air resistance or air drag. So we are also found out the range of that particle, the x, the height, the maximum height it can go, and also the relation between the angle of throwing the ball and all other factors associated with it. So we have found out that the range was, if theta was the angle of throwing and v was the velocity of initial velocity v, and theta was the angle of throwing, and there is a gravitational force acting downwards, if that's the case, then we can say that the range will be 2 v square cos theta sine theta divided by g, right? So we found out the range with that equation, and we have also found out that the total distance or total height it can go, the maximum height, which will be v square sine square theta by 2g, and we have also found out that the time of flight will be 2v sine theta divided by g. So we have found out that these are the different aspects of these projectile motion, which we have already found out. Now we have also found out a relation between the theta and the velocity in the y-axis and the x-axis. So vy can be written as v sine theta, right, using trigonometry itself, and v x will be written as v cos theta, right? So that's also that work, something that we have discussed. Now we, using that, we can say that theta will be tan inverse y by x, or vy by x. So vy by vx, so that's theta for you guys. So we have already found out all these relations. Now what I'm going to introduce is something similar but somewhat different, somewhat a bit more useful for you guys to do the physics problems when you encounter them. So what now we are going to do is the orbit equation. So it's the orbit equation. So what is the use of orbit equation, and what is the advantage of using orbit equation instead of all these resolution and solving? So going into the orbit equation, you can see that if you have a projectile, you are throwing a ball from say this axis to in this point, two points, this is the range and this is the height. So if you do that, then you can easily write down the equation of motion, which is the position equation, first equation. In the x-axis, there is no acceleration, there is no deceleration, there is no gravity. So that means x equal to x0 plus some initial velocity v0 in the x direction times t. So also the y, in the y direction, it will be y will be equal to y0 plus v0 t minus half gt square, right? So that will be y, because there is gravity in this direction, so that's why there came in the gravitational acceleration due to gravity into this equation, and so it is restricting the motion in the y-axis, that's why there is a gravitational. And also from this equation you can easily find out t, which is the time of flight. In the x-axis you can see that t will be x of some t, this one, it is a function of t anyways, x is a function of t, minus x0 divided by v0. So from that you can find it out, right? So we got time. Now we can substitute this time back into the this equation, and you get y must be equal to some y0 plus v0 times x of t minus this is v zero y, right? So this is v zero y. So v zero x of t minus x zero by v zero minus half g times x of t minus x zero by v zero the whole square. So that will be y equation, right? So that's y. Now what you can do is that you can assume that if the projectile, when you are throwing the ball, the initial velocity will be initial position y zero in the y axis will be zero. So y zero, let it be zero, and x zero be zero as well. So if you write down like that, if you assume that the initial starting point is from the origin, so then you can say that y zero is equal to zero and x zero is also equal to zero. So now you can clearly say that, you can substitute that back into this equation. You say v zero y by v zero, this is v zero x, right? So this is v zero x. So v zero y by v zero x, right, times x of t minus half g times g by 1 by times 1 by v zero x times x of t v zero x the whole square times x of t the whole square is the equation. If you substitute the x zero and v zero y zero as zero into that equation, so that's what you get out of that. Now what you can do is that we can so this is an equation. This is an equation where there is y. I'll write it down neatly down below so that it's much more clear. So y zero, this is the orbit equation without v zero y zero and x zero. So it's v zero x times x of t minus half g by v zero x the whole square times x of t the whole square. So that's the equation, and this equation is called the orbital equation. This is the equation for orbital motion. Now what is the use of this equation? Okay, why is this more advantageous compared to the normal projectile solution now, all that? So let's discuss that. So let's understand why is it important. So for that, I'm going to assume that v, so if you have v, which is the initial velocity, then you can resolve it into v zero v of y and v of x. You can do that, right? So you can say that v y must be equal to v sine theta, and v x will be equal to v cos theta. And so if that's the case, from theta and the initial velocity, right, from the theta value and the initial velocity, we can find it out. So if that's the case, let's assume that vy is equal to some I'm assuming that let it be 20 meter per second square second, and this vx be some 10 meter per second, right? So let's assume that. So if that's the case, then we can use this equation. We can use this equation and we can substitute this Vx. V0 x and V0 y are same as V0 Vy and Vx here. Okay. There need not be any confusion about that. So if that's the case, then we can substitute that back into this equation. And you can see that. So y of t will be equal to some v zero y, which is a 20 meter per second, divided by v zero x, which is 10 meter per second, times x of t, or x, let it be x, which is a function of time anyways, minus half g is just let us assume it to be 10. Okay, 9.8 is the accurate value, but I'm pretending that it is around 10 now. And also v zero x, which is vx here, which is the whole square, which is 10 square times x of t the whole square. So if you substitute that back into this equation, you get, what you get is that you get 2x of t minus half of 10 by 100, that is 1 by 20 times x square, right? X square of t. So that's what you get. Now what you can do is that, so you can simplify that. So y is equal to some 2x. So you can simply write the equations as in a simple form. So y is equal to some 2x minus 1 by 20 x square, right? So we got that. So that's the equation of orbit in this case, in this problem. If we are given a v value and a theta value, we can straightforward find the orbit equation from that. Okay, and if you got that, now what you can do is something that is more beneficial, which is that if you have a projectile, this equation, if you plot this equation, so what happens if you plot this equation of y is equal to 2x minus 1 by 20 x square? So you get something like this, right? This will be the plot and this will be a projectile, right? So the projectile is represented in terms of x and y here. So we don't have any time axis, we don't have any theta in this equation, we don't have v zeros, v's and all that value. So we only have x and y's. That's the one added advantage which you can directly see. Now other thing is that if I assume that x equal to some 1 meter, let x be 1 meter, so y will be substituting that back into the equation, so it's 2 times 1 and 1 by 20 times 1 square, so you get a 2 minus 1 by 20, so that will be equal to some 2 minus 0.05, right? So that will be 1.95 meter, so y will be 1.95 meter. So when x equal to 1 meter, so x equal to 1 meter, y value will be equal to 1.95 meter. So 1.95 meter, so when x equal to that, y will be that. So you can easily predict the exact position of the projectile at different points in space. So that's a big advantage. And that is not just that, okay, it is not simply that. That advantage is not something that is enough. We have to find the range, right? We have to find the maximum height, right? So maximum height also need to be found out, the range need to be found out, and we have to find out something like time of flight, right? So we could do that from resolving all those. Now in this, or using this orbit equation, can we find that? Yes, we can. So if you have an equation of y and x, right, and a projectile like that, now what you can see is that dy by dx, right, dy by dx, which is the slope of this line, will be zero at this point, right? At this point the slope of the line will be zero, so this point is important. So at this point you can see that if you have the equation which is y is equal to 2x minus 1 by 20 x square for this particular problem, remember that this particular problem we have this equation, so dy by dx will be 2 minus 1 by 20, 2 by 20, right? So it's 2 minus dy by dx must be equal to 2 minus 2 by 20 x, so that will be equal to 0 at that point, right, at that slope equal to 0. So what will be that point? So you can equate that. So x equal to 20 times 2 by 2, right? So what you got now is 20 meters, right? So at 20 meters you will have the maximum. So the maximum height is at x equal to 20 meters. So x equal to 20 meters you get the maximum. Now that's something that you found out. So what will be the maximum height, right? What will be the maximum height? So all you have to do is just substitute the value back into the equation, this equation, x equal to 20 meters. So you get y will be equal to 2 times 20, 2 times 20 minus 1 by 20, 1 by 20 times 20 square. So that will be 40 minus 20, right? So that's 20 meters. That's a happy coincidence anyway. So it's not actually what I have intended. So the height is also 20 meters. So anyways, it's actually a good coincidence. So height at 20 meters will also be equal to 20 meters. So it's 20 meter height and 20 meter in the x axis. So 20 meters in the y axis as well. So the maximum height it can go in this particular problem, the maximum height it can go is 20 meters at the distance, x distance 20 meters. So that's the maximum height we have found out. So that is equal to 20 meters, right? And now next thing is the range. So this is a parabola. So the innate property of a parabola is that if you have a peak at this point, then the actual trajectory will be the same in this direction as well. So this distance, whatever this distance be, whatever this distance be, the same distance will be in this direction as well. So if you have 20 meters for the peak, then the next 20 meters will be the rest of the trajectory. So you can find out the range. X will be 20 plus 20, so that's 40 meters. So we have found out the range as well. So we have actually found out what the range is. Okay, so range is also found out. Now we have got the height, we have got the range. Now what is remaining is the time of flight. So time of flight, if you assume that in the x-axis itself, right? So x-axis time will be equal to distance by speed, right, or velocity. So distance is just 40 meters, right? So that's the range. So that distance is 40 meters. And the in the x-axis, x direction, we have initially took the problem, started the problem with the assumption that in the x-axis the velocity was 10 meters per second. So we can come back to that and we can just substitute that value. The velocity in the x-axis is just 10 meter per second. So that is 4 seconds. So the time of flight is 4 seconds. So how easily can you do that using the orbit equation? If you all you have to do is just you remember the orbit equation, substitute that back into these problems, and you do that and you get an easy solution. So I hope this is much better than solving the actual projectile, and I hope you guys understood this very well, and all of the best luck for you guys. Okay, thank you for watching. All the best for you guys.